Hello, welcome to a new video. We don't do videos like this. I've never recorded a video with my camera on before.
With my camera on before?
It's my camera, it's not yours.
Oh, yeah, but you stream.
Hashem.
Daniel!
That's different. That's less scary for some reason. This is much scarier.
It's because I'm the only one here to laugh at your jokes.
Bold of you to assume anyone laughs at my jokes when I'm streaming, but you know, I'm here repping the merch. You know, pick it up at...
You don't even know the name of the website, do you?
The Hertz Locker. Okay, right. We're doing some Reddit React content because that's popping.
It's funny.
We're watching a lot of Cody Co. We're on r/ am I the arsehole, by the way.
r/
People don't know if they're in the wrong and they think they're in the right. So they put a little essay out about why they're in the right.
You like to give me essays about why you're right.
And the difference is I'm never the arsehole. So, you know, am I the arsehole for yelling at my wife for taking down a special anniversary painting I bought her so that she could display her sister's basic drawing? Hey y'all, this is such a long story. My wife for 5 years now is a huge fan of Calvin and Hobbes. She has been since she was a teenager. She's 4 to 3 now. For our anniversary, okay, I'm done with this.
Yeah,
I bought her a special one-of-a-kind original painting. It's one-to-one that we keep hung in our bedroom. You know what else keeps hung in the bedroom? It's special because it's symbolic of each of us waiting for the time place that we found each other. Because we found each other later in life, 36 and 31. I don't care. How is that relevant? Fast forward to tonight. I walk upstairs and I see that our painting is laying in one of our dressers.
I'd like to stop you there. When you said he's yelling at his wife, it's a man. Edit, we are both female. When you assume, you make an ass out of you and me. Okay. Lesbians exist, Dan.
Lesbian Visibility Day. I mean, we should have known, because no dude is getting upset over a fucking painting. That should have been a clue. Fast forward tonight, I walk upstairs and I see that our painting is laying on one of our dressers and hung in its place is one of her sister's paintings. She apparently painted this piece recently so that it could hang in our bedroom. Hang in the bedroom of our 10-month-old. A little bit of context. We have two kids, a 2.5-year-old and a 10... Well, you have a problem with me saying 2.5 instead of 2.5-year-old.
A 2.5-year-old.
That says 2.5-year-old. A 2.5-year-old and a 10-month-old. My wife had a previous Calvin and Hobbes painting that her sister did and it hangs in our 2.5-year-old's room, despite me voicing my disapproval. Why would you be voicing your disapproval?
It's just a picture.
Women.
Unless it's of, like, a massive hog.
No, Hob. It's not Calvin and Hog.
After
confronting my wife, she said that she wanted to treat the boys the same, so her sisters painted another pic for our youngest son. Am I the asshole for being mad that she took down our painting to display her sister's? Out of all the possible places to hang this piece, she took down a special sentimental piece. What the fuck? Am I overreacting?
Okay.
Yes.
Yes, because quite frankly,
who gives
who cares?
Shit? Oh my god, who cares?
That was... It was just this particular location that was kind of our little altar. Oh, Christ, what are you, a cult? It felt special to me too, because of the verbal feedback she'd given in the past.
She's gone, I like that. And you're like, yes, oh, fucking get in!
That's nice. I think that is nice.
Oh, great, Aaron.
That I love. I absolutely love.
That's just the air conditioner.
Yeah, this is really about the painting.
It's clearly not really about
the
painting.
It shouldn't be about the painting.
It's not about the painting. The painting is a vessel.
I like that the wife literally said that she only took it down for one night.
Hanging the thing in their bedroom because it was kind of our little altar.
Okay, I mean, that
didn't
was...
enjoy that.
This is our gay room. This is where we do all the lesbian
this
shit.
It's my Lebanese shrine. You're an arsehole.
I think our family, yeah.
You're an arsehole for being upset about a painting.
I'll go so far as to write.
Not an arsehole about being a lesbian.
Yes.
That's fine. My ex-wife and I share 2 children. Our daughter is 13 and our son is 11. She was remarried for 7 years and has 2 children with her late husband. He died a week ago. A week ago? And you're already on...
About a week ago.
This man has been dead a week and they're already posting on Reddit.
Nothing she can do in a week can be that bad. She's like, he's like, this is bullshit. This is too much. It's been a week. Get over it.
My kids were not close to the man. He was a hard ass and the kids found him overly strict. And I agree. He's dead!
He kept on sending me to bed early. He never let me have snacks.
This man is dead. And they're like, he was a piece of shit. They didn't like being around him. She loved the guy though. And when he died last week, she was a mess. As you would be. When the kids saw their mum again, she was halfway through planning the funeral and asked if they would be able to do a reading or something for the funeral. The kids said they wouldn't be able to. The funeral day came and I showed up for my kids. They were hanging back with me a lot and they told me their mum kept watching them, which I witnessed myself. For the funeral, I sat behind them since she wouldn't let them sit with me. She told us that all her husband's kids should be seated up front and I didn't have the heart to tell her they weren't his kids on the day of her husband's funeral when she was such a mess. I just can't go over the fact he's just openly hating this man who died a week ago.
I'm beginning to respect it more. Sorry.
The kids came to sit in my car for a while and we were laughing about something. At a funeral?
You're allowed to laugh at a funeral.
My daughter ended up getting mad at her mum and told her she wasn't sad he was gone. He was an arse and she'd always hoped she would leave him. I told her they were trying to support her and she should be proud of them for that. She started yelling back at me about what an arsehole I am. So I walked away. Am I the arsehole?
I'm going to say no.
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 I thought you were an arsehole because he died a week ago.
So whatever she'd done, it was fine.
He was a hard ass and we just hate him up here. But down here, well, she didn't force the reading. I think the thing that she was most upset about was the fact they were laughing in a car.
We don't know the context. It might have been watching, you know.
Maybe he told one banger of a joke.
Maybe he was watching that clip of KSI saying the P word. We don't know. I'm just going to date this video.
Excellent.
Not an arsehole?
Not an arsehole.
All right, I'm going to say you get a pass.
So, my 14, so, my 14-foot family.
I always forget what that means.
14 female.
I mean, I know, I worked it out. It's not that hard to work out the system. But
totally exploded while I was on spring break 2 weeks ago.
Spring break!
Take him off the glass! Take him off the glass!
Yeah.
Went on a trip with my grandparents and came back to my mum, moved out, and a serious sit-down talk about them divorcing. It's not exactly a surprise because they've both been acting weird and shady for a while, but like, that's not what I was expecting to come back to.
They are foreign agents.
And they could have let me unpack first, at least. They asked me if I had any questions, and I asked them which one cheated because that was my first thought. They got super uncomfortable and said that the reasons between them were private. I said not what it means I suddenly lost my family over it, and they owe me at least some reason that this is happening, and we don't love each other anymore doesn't cut it. I told them that I don't want to live with either of them if they're going to be like that.
Hold on, wait. I saw a post where someone said, I tried to convince my wife to peg me for like 6 months, and when she finally did, I shit all over her and the bed, and we haven't spoken for a week. And I like to think that these...
What do you think this is why?
This is the same
That's
story.
The actual meaning.
That's why they're getting a divorce, because he shit all over her.
Okay. I told them both that if they were going to hide stuff, I'll just make up my own worst case and go with that. Since mum left, it can be all her fault. Since it's her fault, I won't live with her or go see her. She got upset and said that was unfair and it wasn't her fault. What if your dad, like, murdered someone, but because your mum won't tell you why, you're like, mum, no.
If your father murdered someone, his wife, your mother, should go to the police and have him arrested and not just leaving you in the house with the murderer. I mean, like, oh yeah, just come visit. I'll come visit me on weekends.
I told her to give me the real reason then, or just deal with it. Pretty sure at least one of them will crack and tell me what happened soon, so I can decide how I feel about it. If one of them did something bad, I want to know. If they won't own up or explain why there are no bad guys, they can both be the bad guy.
Duh.
Am I the arsehole?
You're the arsehole, Jesus kid. Your parents are having far more decorum in this divorce than most divorcing parents ever have. If they're not at each other's throats and trying to make things as smooth as for you as possible, you can at least show a little decorum. Give them... Stop saying decorum, bro. You're not cool just because you know the word decorum. Thoughts?
Yes, you're an arsehole.
Yeah, I mean, you're also like 12 years old, so it's understandable you're an arsehole because, and I mean this, every 14-year-old is an arsehole.
Would I be the arsehole for evicting my roommate because she wouldn't pay my vet bills? I, 33 female, live with my friend Rose 30, who is a cyborg.
Does she know how brackets work?
Probably not. Rose.
Bitch, get some parentheses up in here.
30. Rose had multiple plants and had them up on our back porch. My cat goes out to the back porch as it is screened in and consumed some of these flowers and got very sick. Turns out one of the plants were lilies, which are toxic to cats. I took her to the vet immediately, and they told me if I hadn't, she probably would have died. I kindly asked Rose if she would pay for my cat's vet bill since her flowers caused this, in which she became super offended and refused, saying it wasn't her fault because she didn't know and that this was an accident. I basically told her if she didn't at least split the bill with me, she'd have to find somewhere else to live.
I don't know if they're both idiots. Like, I just don't... Do you know what I mean? Do people not think that plants are bad? Like, some plants are bad for you? People see green and they're like, that must be good.
If you cared that much, you would be like, are these safe for my cat? You wouldn't wait until the cat ate them and nearly died and then suddenly be like, Rose, you're an arsehole. You would do your research if you cared that much.
I actually don't, I'm going to change my answer. Because if it was a normal house and the cat was like able to go out somewhere and it went into a neighbor's house and ate their plant, you would never in a million years be like,
pay my cat's vet bill.
Yeah, what the fuck? Hey, John next door, is that a lily in your garden? You owe me some dollars. Like, that would never happen. You can't do that.
I even agreed to split it. Like, the woman who owns the cat.
Oh, okay. She agreed to split it.
Yeah, I feel like it's good because you're sort of admitting that, yeah, it's my cat. My bad. Drop the ball. But also, your plants almost killed my cat. Would you be the arsehole for evicting your roommate?
No, but you'd put the rent up.
Definitely. Put the rent up.
Until it covers the bill.
Yeah, exactly. Up the rent till it covers the bill and then drop it back down.
Or just don't, because no one ever drops rent.
And no more plants in the house, I guess.
It's actually on the balcony. No, just get rid of the lily.
On the back porch,
just get rid
they
of...
don't have a balcony.
A porch is just a ground floor balcony. Fight me. I will fight you over that. That's
anyway,
what a porch is.
No, not an arsehole.
All right. Thank you for joining us, everyone.
Yippee.
I hope this is interesting. A bit different.
Just push me all the way out of shot.
Get out of shot. This is my YouTube channel, guys. Hit that like and subscribe. Oh, get in the shot. What the hell? I'm using you for views.
Ahoy.
Remember, everyone has to click this button. What does it say, Erin?
Like.
Smash it. Smash the like.
Smash the like.
I want everyone to smash this thing right here.
Can you not point at me when you
smash
say
this?
Smash
this. What is it, Erin?
Subscribe.
And this one?
I don't...
What's this?
Your Twitch link?
Yeah, shit.
Oh.
I stream on Twitch. Yeah, come and watch us there.
You do?
I can just cut it here. Keep waving. Keep waving for the camera. Keep waving.